Today, we will talk about the top 5 weapon systems showcased at the Defense Expo 2022. First weapon system is DRDO LnT FICV. DRDO and LnT are working on a futuristic platform, which can serve as multiple types of armored fighting vehicles, including infantry combat vehicle, for the Indian Army. Indian Army has a requirement of 1750 units of futuristic infantry combat vehicles. Now it's officially conformed, the hull design is based on DRDO Obey ICV. Instead of metallic hull, used in Obey, FICV uses composite armored hull, which matches the structural and ballistic performance of metallic hull, with 35% weight reduction. It can provide protection against 14.5mm armor-piercing round. Currently, FICV is undergoing mobility and functional trials. LnT also showcased its FICV concept, or maybe it is the final configuration of DRDO LnT FICV. It has a shooting capacity for only 6 soldiers. Second weapon system is light tank. The tank will weigh around just 25 tons, and it can be transported by air, rail, and road. With superior firepower, protection, surveillance, and greater communication capabilities, the light tank is capable to defeat the adversary's armor, low-flying helicopters, and fortifications. If you observe the tank model closely, it is equipped with a 105mm gun, remote-controlled weapon station, smoke grenades, electro-optical sight, more precisely panoramic sight for commander, and metallurgical mast. Is coaxial machine gun, gunner sight, radar, and hard-kill launcher missing here? Well, this is just a model, most likely prototype will include all equipment. The tank will have a crew of 3 on board, and it can move in the water. It seems like both FICV and light tank are based on the same hull. The light tank will be rollout next year. Personally, I would like to see a modular platform, where armor can be increased and decreased as per the requirements. Kalyani also unveiled its next generation light tank design. According to the chairman of the Kalyani group, the tank will be ready within a year. Third weapon system is wheeled armored fighting vehicle, showcased by 4 different companies, TATA, Mahindra, Larsen and Toubro, and Kalyani. TATA showcased 3 different variants of Kestrel. First one is the wheeled light tank, with a 105mm gun. If you look closely, the light tank is based on TATA IPMV instead of TATA Kestrel. The turret design is totally clean, with no ATGM, no sight, no secondary weapon, and even no active protection system. This variant looks like an improvement over TATA IPMV. It features a more secure driver section, water jets, smoke grenades, for ATGM, electro-optical sight, and a 30mm cannon. TATA also showcased the armored personnel carrier variant of the Kestrel. Mahindra showcased 2 different variants of the wheeled armored fighting vehicle. Light tank and infantry combat vehicle. Both vehicles are based on a single 8x8 wheeled armored fighting vehicle. The light tank features remote-controlled weapon station, radar, active protection system with hard kill and soft kill launcher, electro-optical sight, and a 105mm cannon. Infantry combat vehicle features ATGM, active protection system, electro-optical sight, and a 30mm cannon. Larsen and Toubro and Kalyani also showcased wheeled armored fighting vehicles. Larsen and Toubro armored vehicle features 4 ATGM, water jets, smoke grenades, and a 30mm cannon. Kalyani wheeled armored fighting vehicle looks like Turkey's firm, ARMA, wheeled armored combat vehicle. Nothing is yet officially confirmed. Fourth weapon system is BMP-2. Armored Vehicles Nigam Limited Showcase Upgraded BMP-2. It is equipped with an aviation system, Palm 120 loitering ammunition, that can carry 4.5 kilograms of warhead, and has an endurance of 60 minutes. It is also integrated with a 5.5 kilometers 5th gen Spike ATGM. It features third-generation sighting system for gunner and commander, integrated fire control system, multifunctional display, auto-target tracking, and display for troops, to improve situational awareness. Armored Vehicles Nigam Limited also showcase another upgraded BMP-2, with Israeli firm Rafael Samson MK-2 unmanned turret. It also features third-generation sighting system for gunner and commander, electro-optical fire control system and weapon control, 30mm autocannon, coaxial gun, and two Spike LR-ATGM. Currently, the Indian Army operates 2,500 units of BMP-2. All BMP-2s will be upgraded to BMP-2M standards by the Indian Army. Fifth weapon system is Garuda Vajra. Garuda Aerospace unveiled its new flying wing designed unmanned combat aerial vehicle. It features a LiDAR high-quality day and night thermal camera at the nose for surveillance and live video streaming from dense forests to mountain areas. It is also able to carry 5 kilograms of small drone-launched ammunition in an internal weapon bay. It will be powered by a single jet engine that produces 24 kilograms thrust, with 90 kilograms per minute fuel consumption. The engine is designed and manufactured by HAL. Garuda Aerospace has signed a partnership with CDL Lockheed Martin for providing advanced uncrewed aerial systems software solutions for Vajra. Garuda Aerospace describes it as high-efficiency, jet-powered, tactical drone. It can travel around India in 16 hours, with 3 stops for refueling. It has to be seen how Garuda Vajra will stand against Swift UCAV. Defense Expo 2022 is the biggest ever defense exhibition, witnesses 451 Memorandum of Understanding, Transfer of Technology Agreements, and product launches during the ceremony. Envisages investment worth 1.5 lakh crore Indian rupee. Indian Air Force and HAL conclude a contract for 70 HTT-40 Indigenous Basic Trainer aircraft, worth 6,800 crores Indian rupee. Defense Minister Shri Rajnath Singh said, "The government is committed to the growth of the public and private sector to fulfill the twin objectives of complete self-reliance and increased defense exports." He also said, "Self-reliance does not mean establishing supremacy, it is to ensure that the nation remains protected from all threats." Raksha Mantri terms Defense Expo 2022 as the beginning of a new era of self-reliance, New India, fully ready to stand shoulder to shoulder with major world powers. That's it for today, see you in the next video.